Hey, what's up, guys? This is HDX here. I just had a long day. My legs are just killing me at this point here. And I've been checking out some news here and here and then. And I just want to let you know that I am a big wrestling fan. I mean, I've been a big wrestling fan since I was a kid. I've been reading some stuff going on here recently. And I have just been saddened. I mean, I've saddened by the suspensions of Alberto Del Rio and one of my favorite female wrestlers in WWE, Paige. Yes, these two have violated the WWE wellness policy, and now these two are suspended for 30 days. I mean, I am saddened after when I heard the news that a friend told me that Alberto Del Rio has somehow got suspended, and then afterwards, Paige got suspended, which I just felt devastated. I always loved Paige. I mean, when I first saw her in NXT back about like 2 to 3 years ago, I remember, like, I mean, she's one hell of an ass kicker from Great Britain. I mean, the youngest NXT champion, NXT women's champion, the youngest WWE Divas champion, I mean, at the age of 21, like, holy shit. I mean, she's about my age at this point. But I digress. I mean, I just still feel saddened that she got suspended. I hope that she'll come back bigger, better than ever, and I hope that she'll get her act together. And I mean, those two, Del Rio and Paige, like, you always have my, I mean, you always got my support, you always have my hopes. Oh wait, technically Paige was 19 when she won the NXT Women's Championship. I just made a technicality, just so you know. Now, that being said, I just found out that there is a silver lining, even though, I'm gonna be totally honest, I mean, I was just laughing my ass off when I found out that there is one particular individual who is a complete bust, no pun intended. Guess who also violated the WWE wellness policy? Here it is. Bing! Ding! You get it, Eva the redheaded dumbass Marie! Yes, Eva Marie has been suspended from the WWE. The organization suspended the Total Diva star for 30 days for violating the WWE's wellness policy. A statement on the WWE's website reads, "This WWE has suspended Natalie Coyle, aka Eva Marie, for 30 days, effective immediately, for her first violation of the company's talent wellness policy. Eva Marie has yet to comment on her suspension since news broke out recently. The E-Star was originally scheduled to be at SummerSlam this Sunday, but she will not be in attendance due to her suspension. Eva Marie was supposed to be a part of the six-woman tag at SummerSlam. I mean, a six-woman tag team match at SummerSlam, but it would be now a 3-on-2 handicap match without her." Yeah, and as you can see here, the E! Network star, she's not even a professional wrestler. She's just a reality TV star. For real, though. No, seriously. Eva Marie can't wrestle for fucking shit. Not even by a long shot. Like, for real, though, look at the occupation under her name. Actress. Not professional wrestler. Actress. Fucking actress. And a reality TV star at that. And I'm sorry, but I'm not sorry. This is funny as hell. And what I mean by that is that WWE hyped and built up one of the most terrible divas / women wrestlers in recent memory. She gets trained by Brian Kendrick and is still absolutely garbage in the ring. Yet WWE give her this totally over-the-top entrance, keep building her up, and she goes and just fucks it up. I mean, let's be totally honest. I just think she's just a shit wrestler and she doesn't deserve this hype at all. There's so many women that deserve the hype and building up who can wrestle, like Naomi, who has a huge fan base, by the way. Don't get me wrong. Becky Lynch, Natalya, Carmella. Well, you know what? Scratch that. I mean, Alexa Bliss, Paige, Asuka. I mean, I can go on and on and on. Bayley, Sasha Banks. Sasha Banks is one of the best. I mean, those wrestlers can, these female wrestlers can kick ass and take names in the ring any day of the week, whatever it's in the main roster or hell, even in NXT. I mean, NXT has the best in-ring product. I mean, let me tell you that much. Always in-ring quality, just freaking awesome. And they can wrestle, and they can wrestle ring around circles all over Eva Marie. They can ring around Eva Marie circles every single day. Look, all I'm trying to say is this, and let's call it what it is. Eva Marie can't wrestle for shit, and yet she's still hyped up because for whatever reason, WWE is just high all over her red hair. High all over her red hair and her good looks. That's it. And to any of you Eva Marie fans say, oh, you're just hating. No. Shut the fuck up, man. Just, like, seriously, shut the fuck up. How can you be a fan of a female wrestler who can't wrestle for dog shit? Like, seriously, though. I mean, you must be out of your damn mind. Like, seriously. Look, let's just call it for what it is. Let's be real about it. She can't even wrestle for dog shit. And I tell you, when SmackDown drafted her, I just facepalmed. I was like, what the fuck were you thinking, SmackDown? What the fuck were you thinking? And let me tell you, I mean, that draft was just a failure. I mean, a failure for the most part from the looks of it. I mean, let's just be real about this. I mean, seriously, when they drafted her on SmackDown, I mean, what do? They just hyped her up and they hyped her up. And after every entrance, they make her do something. I mean, she does something stupid, like, I mean, no, my ankles, and then this and that. And recently, the traffic stopped, and there's only one highlight that just, I mean, look at this.
Becky Lynch is good, but good.
Commercial?
I've heard of wardrobe malfunctions. What's going on?
Where's her stylist? She has a whole glam squad. Send one of them down here.
Oh, no.
Listen, due to a wardrobe malfunction, she cannot compete tonight. Wardrobe malfunction, no match. No match.
Ladies and gentlemen, due to a wardrobe malfunction, Eva Marie cannot compete, and therefore this match will not take place.
Yes, a match between Becky Lynch and Eva Marie was canceled due to a wardrobe malfunction. I can't make this up. Yes, the timing was funny. Okay, the timing was funny, and yeah, we could see you like covering her boobs there and whatnot. I mean, it was hot. But all that being said, what was the purpose of all that? Like, seriously, like, what was the purpose of all that? Thanks for wasting my time, damn it! Thanks for wasting the 5 and 6 minutes that I'm never gonna get back and making Becky Lynch subject herself with kind of bullshittery, the fuckery that just went down on TV. I can't believe Becky Lynch had to subject herself. Oh, poor, poor girl. Alright, so I'm gonna end this video right here. Give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. I'm HDX, signing out. Have a good one.